The argument here is that the majority of the Ugandan population observes either Christianity or Islam, and the religious leaders have full access to the vulnerable people under their control.
Almost 90% of the people in this country, they go to the church, they go to the mosque, and they believe in God. So if they believe in God, it is better the religious leaders to handle them in the mosque or in the churches. Then we work together to make sure that we finish corruption in this country.
The religious leaders observe that by giving them full control of government wealth creation initiatives like the parish development model and the Emioga, the direct beneficiaries will easily be identified.
We have this government program like a parish development model should handle by the religious leaders. Those are the people they know, poor people in community. Like Emioga can handle by the religious leaders. They know who are the beneficiaries.
Ismail Ali Omona is the imam of the Gulu main mosque. Here he is talking to me on the street of a bank lane in Gulu city. His compatriot Ahmed Oriem from Lamu Kitgum Muslim district sees schools as an opportunity for the government to reprogram the citizens against corruption.
The government should take back the school and every institution back to the what? To the religious institutions, so that they start grooming the young ones.
And now listen to this gentleman.
People are corrupt because corruption is in the heart.
His name is Pastor Okello Sam, and he works with the Favor of God Ministries in Gulu. Pastor Okello quotes the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 from the Bible to further emphasize the need for the government to involve religious leaders in the heart of the fight against corruption.
It's very important for the religious leaders to be involved in the fight against corruption. So I believe this engagement is very key for the future of our nation and the integrity of the people of Uganda.
The rallying cry from these religious leaders comes at a time when the office of the president has intensified the fight against corruption. For example, on the 25th of August 2022, six technocrats from Gulu City Council were arrested by the State House Anti-Corruption Unit. As we speak now, the permanent secretary at the Directorate of Ethics and Integrity, Alex Okello, has ordered all those implicated in corruption to be sent home as investigations continue.
Once a public officer is charged in court with a criminal offense, and corruption is already a criminal offense, she must be interdicted by the responsible officer.
Corruption is a criminal offense in Uganda. The office of the LOC1s, the police force, and the local government have been identified as harboring some of the most corrupt individuals in the country.
Take zero tolerance to corruption. If anybody has said, even if he's a very good officer and you don't want to lose him, if he said that he has been corrupt and the like, let the process take full course.
It now remains to be seen how the Directorate of Ethics and Integrity and the religious leaders can merge efforts to zero tolerance to corruption. Joseph Omagor.